Hello, Cubers. As many of you probably remember, this is a puzzle I've made a long time ago. It is called the 5x6x7 floppy iCube Extreme. And what it is, it basically is a 7x7 where I've glued two layers together. So these three layers is this one, and then I glued another two layers in this direction. So these two layers is actually this one here. So I wanted to expand this idea of gluing different layers in different directions. And I thought of making it in other puzzles as well. So I made this version here, which is made from a 6x6x6 puzzle, as you can see. This one is here is made from this puzzle, where this face, this layer here, is actually these three layers here, just like that. And this layer here is actually these two layers here. Now, because this is an even puzzle, and if I wanted to cut down these three layers, it's not possible, as many of you know, in an even layered puzzle. So I decided to extend the bottom of the puzzle. So if you can see this, let's put it like that. This layer is the top layer. The next one is like that. The next one is this one, and the top layer is actually extended. In you can see them. Just a moment. I will put them like that. You can see how much the bottom layer has been extended. Also, you can see it here, how much it is extended. In order to make the puzzle look nice, also because I've bandaged these two layers together, this layer here is actually these two layers here. So I extended the red face. So if I align the two puzzles, it is like that. You can see that the bottom layer here is extended by this amount. You can see it better here, how much I've extended the puzzle. Now, this is a very interesting puzzle, as you probably understand, because of the extreme bandaging and the extreme shape shifting due to the extensions. But I have to admit that it was a very difficult puzzle to make. Making puzzles with extensions is always difficult, but in this one, because you can see I extended these layers here. Better make it like that. I extended them very much, so it was difficult to make it to make the extensions straight and make them look good. But the end result is very nice. I like it a lot. I think the puzzle is very beautiful, and as you can see, the turning is also very nice. and the it will probably be a very challenging puzzle to solve. Now, just a moment. Oh, I have messed it up. Anyway, I'm gonna try to bring it back and come back to you again. Oop. There it is. I got it back together. It wasn't so difficult because I knew. Anyway, you can see how easily this puzzle gets scrambled. Now, of course, in order to have a full puzzle family, you need to extend it even more. So, I made this puzzle here, which is made from a 5x5. You can see it here. Of course, because this one is an evil layered puzzle, it was easy to sand it down. This one is made from this puzzle, a 5x5. Now, because it is an evil layered puzzle, it is easy to sand it down, and so I didn't use the extensions in order to make it. So, if I try to explain it, this top layer here is actually these three layers. You can see that now the badging goes beyond the center of the puzzle. Also, this layer here is these two layers. You can see like that. Now, to tell you the truth, I haven't scrambled this puzzle yet, and I don't actually know what challenges it can provide. But basically, because the badging, you can see it here in a sort of checkerboard pattern, but because in this puzzle the badging goes beyond the center of it, I think that it will be very, very challenging in solving, but I don't know yet. Now, of course, I couldn't stay there, and I made an even smaller version, which is this one here. This is the 2x1, 2x3, 2x4 floppy iCube Extreme. And this one is based on a 4x4 puzzle like that. And of course, as you can understand, I also used extensions in making this puzzle, because it is an even layered puzzle. So this top layer here is actually these three layers, all of them, you can see it there, and the bottom layer, this one, is this one. So in this puzzle the badging goes even beyond the center of the puzzle by a full layer. So if this is the center of the puzzle, the badging goes beyond. So you can see here I also used extensions. This is I extended the red face by that amount of extensions. You can see it here maybe a bit better. And I also extended the yellow face by that big. You can see how big these extensions are. And I have to tell you that it was very difficult and challenging to make it to make those extensions look that beautiful. I really like the end result of this puzzle very much. So of course, as you can guess, this puzzle probably will also be a very challenging puzzle. You can see how much it shape shifts. And this is the whole Floppy Eye Cube Extreme family. This is the 2x3x4. This is the 3x4x5, like that. This is the 4x5x6, and of course this one is the 5x6x7. Actually, this particular one is the first one I have ever made. You can understand it probably. The quality is not very good, but it's a pretty nice puzzle. Anyway, this is the whole Floppy Eye Cube Extreme family. I hope you like it. Bye.